Look at me, motherfucker, look at me, look at me, look at me, motherfucker, look at me, look at me. And when you see me, bitch, tell me what you see, what you see. Look at me, motherfucker.
Okay, so now I'm going to put the gloves on and we are going to begin now. So the needle that I'm going to be using is a 3-rounded liner. And if you don't know what a 3-rounded liner is, it's like basically the smallest needle there is, I think. I'm not sure. But anyways, this is a 3-rounded liner. And I'm going to go ahead and put her on the machine. That's how she sounds like, and that's how much she's coming out. Shouldn't be more than that. Before I start, I'm going to go ahead and prep the skin. I'm going to use an alcohol pad. Just in case you wanted to know what the alcohol does, it disinfects the area. Also, just in case your skin has oils and stuff like that, it takes away the oils from the skin. And I heard that the only way to get the ink off of this fake skin is to use a lot of petroleum jelly, aka Vaseline. So we have some Vaseline right here, right next to us. I do switch out my gloves every once in a while, but since this is not an actual client, I'm not going to be switching my gloves out as often because I want to save my materials for an actual client. So now that we went ahead and did that, we are going to go ahead and use this stencil stuff. I also did wrap this around some plastic wrap. I'm gonna go ahead and just put this all over here. And if you didn't know what stencil stuff is, this is the serum or whatever it is that makes the stencil stick on the skin. And yeah, this is the one that I use. There's a lot of people who make homemade remedies, and you know, you do whatever you feel like is more comfortable for you. So here I'm going to go ahead. You know what, I feel like it needs a, it should be okay right there. I'm going to go ahead and let it dry a little. And here I go. Wow, you see how, since it was a little wet, I should have left it to dry a little bit longer. The stencil ink went everywhere, but it's cool. As long as you can see where the lines are, everything is a-okay. So, now we begin. I like to dip my ink just 2 times, and I do clean it off like this so that the ink won't get clogged up, because it does dry up. So before, I'm going to go ahead and put some Vaseline on the area that I'm going to start off. So I'm going to go ahead and start off. Oh, let's clean that up. Well, isn't that a bummer? Well, anyways, I'm gonna go ahead and start showing y'all. So if this was to be real skin, you would have to be stretching it, but since it's not, just pretend like you are. It's not that complicated to keep a straight line. You just have to concentrate. As you guys can see, this needle is the skinniest needle, and since it's the skinniest needle, you want to be careful on how deep you put the needle. So for example, here you just have to like slightly put the needle in. You don't have to dig it in, because if you dig it in, you will hurt the client's skin or whoever you're tattooing. And it's not going to be nice for them. They will be moving a lot. You want your customer or client to be comfortable, especially if it's their first tattoo. People do tend to move a lot when it is their first tattoo. But that is basically what you have to do. You just have to keep a steady hand. Make sure you concentrate. And you see how it gets dirty here. I'm going to go ahead and wipe it down all with Vaseline. But as you can see, it like already smudged everywhere. So yeah, I'm gonna just try my best to fix this up, and I'll get back with y'all. Just show y'all how it looks, the whole process. Now I'm going to go ahead and share a tip that somebody once shared to me. Now, if you ever have seen a plane land and take off, that is basically the image that goes through my head whenever I'm about to put the needle in. So I go ahead and just slowly go down. I go ahead and go straight. And when I'm ready to take off, I go lightly off. So that is what I'm going to do here. Go slowly down. Go slowly up. And here are the little fingers. The reason why I use a three-rounded liner is because it can get the small details that you want. So. If you're wondering what ink I'm using the dynamic ink. Also, these cartridges are from, well, this cartridge is from Big Wasp. So I have a little stencil here. Since it's smudged, I can go ahead and see the outline. Go ahead and wipe it every single time. I dip it once again so that the needle will not get clogged up. It's really important to keep a steady hand and a light hand whenever you are tattooing somebody else, because you do not want their skin to be irritated fast. You want it to be a pretty canvas, you feel me? This is like so satisfying to me. Y'all don't even understand. I'm happy that I could help other people out. Cause whenever I started off, I didn't have anyone to help me. Or any videos that actually like showed. So here I'm going to leave this part for the last, because yeah, since I told y'all, oh look how dirty it's getting, oh my goodness, what a mess. Very satisfying. And now for the part I've been waiting for, the lovely wings. So now for the finale. Alright, so now that I'm done doing the little angel, I'm gonna go ahead and try and take all this ink off. Thank the Lord, it will not be that hard to take ink off of human skin. This is what it looks like to have straight lines. And that will be all for this video. Honestly, it's already long enough. But basically, this is how to make straight lines, honey. It looks really nice. I personally would like to go over all of it one more time just to bring out, you know, a thicker line so that these lines here would look smaller. And that is what I'm going to do, but I will get back at y'all when I'm done with it, and I'm just show y'all a close up. This is what the setup looks like when I'm all done. The Vaseline is all gone because I took
all of the excess ink off, and it's a little messy, but I tried my hardest to take off all of the ink. But I went ahead and did the whole outline again. Like I was saying, the outlining looks a little bit more thicker, and the little itty bitty lines in the inside look smaller. So yeah, that's basically my little video. I hope you guys enjoyed it, and if y'all want more videos like this, more content like this, let me know. Please go ahead and like, comment, and subscribe for more. Thank you.